Welcome everyone to another update here. We earlier submitted upstream this OBS changes for our key binding, super small, simple fix. And yeah, of course it was rejected or something like that. Where was it even? Probably here, pull request. So pro tip, check your commit style and messages before you submit stuff upstream, otherwise you do the work twice or something like that. Also, the new age of open source just rejects this stuff because of commit message. So please hear from someone 43 minutes ago. Please check contribution guidelines. Your commit title is incorrect. So thank you for that. Also, in previous times, you know what I said earlier, good old fashioned email, you just commit the stuff. I mean, not only it takes like 10 times more time to submit the stuff with all the remote Git stuff and web stuff and everything. Now I can even correct this or update this or whatever. Again, in my opinion, 20 years ago when I was a young Padawan, somehow this was, in my opinion, more amazing. So how do we do this? So the commit message is just git amend, I think. Am I in the right? Is not amend. What was it? Did I not? What? Where do we have this? Did I not have this somewhere? Squish. Come on. So this is push brand amend. Ah, okay. Also with minus minus and then with all typos. So maybe. Come on. Yeah, so much to not native English speaking. Ah, commit amend. Oh, I can't mix this shit up. Git commit. Was it this? You get the idea. Commit amend with D. Maybe. Ah, come on. Like that. So they want us that we put here libobs, I think it was. So the if you click on this commit title, contribution guidelines. Yada yada yada, a lot of stuff similar to Linux kernel, whatsoever, something and so on. And then, for example, libobs. So they want that we put here libobs. And then let's double check. So capital, no punctuation, something. And then maybe not just, but add a couple of more Unix hotkey defines, whatever. And then I think two commands. So then we need to push this. That should probably show this in git log libobs at yeah. Also, you don't need to open web stuff. Another pro tip, just look here in the git log history. Then you can already get some style here. So that probably hopefully satisfies their weird quirks. Git push, I think. And then comes the magic of. What are we even showing here? So then, okay, that fails. Fun stuff. Failed to push some refs. Updates were rejected because of tip of your crim branch is behind the remote counterpart. What? Yeah, and then you wonder that I. What? Why is this in merge? I don't really quite understand this. What has this done? There should not be something to merge. It's ridiculous in my opinion. So here is this again. So yeah, this is exactly the recurring theme here. I am completely not really getting my head wrapped against this git nonsense. If you do more than a little bit, it always is strange. I had the same thing. Comment in the comments how too stupid we are to get fall in love with Git here. Anyway, I wanted to let's delay this for a second. I just don't really quite understand why this is some merge conflict nonsense thing. I wanted to do one more thing anyway, because I'm really wondering the state of open source here. They only complain about the commit message when we actually have something more serious. That if I would be the maintainer, I actually would have had something else to complain, which is this if hash if preprocessor macro if one that I had here, because I was thinking to maybe that needs to be conditionalized for if you have actually this headers. And there I really wonder the state of review, but whatever. So let's tweak this. I think this was for sure in OBS Nix C. So if one, let's delete this maybe, and I don't know, put this, yeah, leave it like this. How many? So they could also complain, but they have here some separation white spacing, so yeah, whatever. And then git commit modified this. And yeah, if you have comments how to use git more amazingly, removed if zero. Oops. Does this membrane keyboard not get all key presses, or that comes from that? So then we have now the problem that we have removed if one, merge, here's this nonsense libobs stuff, where again I really don't quite understand how this even happens, but similar shit happens with my PS3 RSX stuff. So what we want to do now anyway is, and let's see what happens with git pull. Okay, already up to date, amazing stuff. What I anyway had to do, which is why I delayed this conflict nonsense, merge nonsense there for a second, is to squash this, something similar that I've done already. So that probably should be like maybe this, or squash commits locally. So this I think was like four commits something, but there you see my recurring pattern here, git is too complicated. Let's see how many commits this were, like 1, 2, 3, 4. So maybe this is rebase this 4, let's see. This would be pick, no, somehow this is doing more, so this merge stuff is doing. Then let's try only one, what, or two, what, okay, now it needs git rebase board, I guess. And this is also not what we wanted. So added a couple of more, just a couple of, so this looks maybe like we wanted. And of course now we have here this three stuff, this libobs added this, and so let's see, commands pick, use commit, so pick this, and so how does it, I think, these lines can be reordered, they are executed, if you remove the line. So did it do something? Nothing to commit. Working tree clean, could not apply, just a couple of, what do they mean with could not apply? But we are now at this commit, this is really so strange. Let's see, do we still have this change in here or not? Oh, this reappeared. Yeah, another failed live stream. It's ridiculous. I really don't understand. You need to basically have to study Git for like a year or two to become a master of Git mastering. And tell me how to Let's clone this shit again. Let's waste here 20 megabyte, 30 megabyte of bandwidth. Let's do this again. This is usually what I usually start from scratch because this Git stuff is just something. Commit. Let's try this fresh. Removed if this. Let's take a look on the log. Yes, no, we don't have this merge nonsense. I really don't understand. I committed this, I pushed this. I really don't understand why there is this strange thing. So then git the squash thing. A rebase, is it one or two? This is probably one. Let's see if this is doing something. Successfully rebased and updated. Let's see. Git log. Yeah, somehow they are still both in here though, which I don't really quite like. Why is this not squashed in one commit? And then force the push. Yeah, I just don't really quite understand how to squash commits after they have been pushed. Git branching, rebasing. Does not work, that have already been pushed. When I do, could not apply, okay, this looks similar to git base. I did this actually and then force the push. Note that force, you can force origin master. Here, someone in the audience, by the way, is something on a branch that was, let's see, checkout, commit, push, does this do something better? Your local changes to the following files would be overwritten by the merge. It's ridiculous. Someone in the audience, you're probably so much more smarter than me in using Git. Please enlighten me how this crap should work and why does it need to be so complicated. This is the reason, yes, I'm totally old-fashionedly using Subversion, but at least this stuff works and is not such a complicated mess that even I don't fail to get. And also why, this is why I even was more fan of Mercurial, or that is produced. On a branch I was able to do this. Check out my branch. A lot of problems can be avoided by only creating a branch. Minor difference to the accepted answer, but I was having a lot of difficulty squashing. Finally got it. Rebase head. At the interactive screen, opens up replace pick with squash. Oh, squash. Okay, we need to make the squash maybe. Yeah, life learning. Danny, welcome. Don't you know Git? Can you not enlighten me how to use this Git stuff? And again, in my opinion, computer science or open source, I don't know, version control. So then maybe it is meant to be used like this. Squash. What does happen now? What happened? What? This is a commit of two commits. Maybe this is a commit message of two. Successfully rebased and updated. Maybe this worked. Just a couple of more defines. Amazing stuff. Git push. Maybe that worked. Failed to push some refs. We probably need some force, right? Yes, we need force. That force something amazing. Let's see what we have done there. So the thing is, one also needs to be really careful with this stuff, because the last time I tried this, which ironically was with the Linux minidisc stuff, to some Debian people, a person who also was nitpicking on this kind of commit message stuff and such. Let's see what we got here now. 8 hours ago is, by the way, okay, we probably need to reload that. No, this is again. Oh, this actually. So, the funny thing is, this lost some history, right? So, this irritates me a little bit. Committed 8 hours ago. Okay, fine. However, the change changed now, right? Before we hit the F1, in my opinion, this is not entirely super amazing correct. This should not be 8 hours ago, but 8 seconds ago, but whatever. I'm not the magician of this Git magic. A lot of progress in... I've seen a lot of progress in T2 lately, yeah, so lala. Of course, we do updates here each and every day that you see here. Changelog, not the most major stuff. Although, yeah, well, you know, there is usually a commit like each and every day. If there is not a commit each and every day, either there was nothing upstream or I was flying, working, but here we have some amazing commit graph. Going back to this change, so the last time I've done this with this GitHub integration, it actually updated the pull request. Let's see if this happened here now as well. Let's see, just a wait a second, did I, by the way, let's click on this. Oh, wait a second, did I, oops, I think I forgot to amend the commit message now, so much to that. Amend, so yeah, this was slip obs add more xorg hotkey defines. The problem is maybe I now have the same issue with pushing this. Let's see, push force. What happens? No, it forced something, maybe. Maybe it worked now. Let's refresh this and some checks. So you see this, I think this even just in this dynamic HTML stuff just refreshed here, maybe force pushed. Let's see. So now here are two things 4 minutes ago, 2 minutes ago. The last thing is now this one and libobs add more xorg unix hotkey defines and all the integration testing is testing again, which is also funnily slow. The last time this took really long, 30 minutes or whatnot. Yeah, not the greatest Git something here. Professor PhD stuff, so no idea if they will accept this. Because now here are two changes, so I'm not really sure. Need to ask, by the way, is this... Where is the comment now? I wanted to. So now the comment disappeared, or wait a second. Yeah, so much to all this web dynamic integration magic. So now somehow we apparently maybe lost the comments there. So hey, they even call it also pro tip. Amazing. Is this not pro tip? Okay, then we need to change this to. Yeah, so everything is amazing in Git and dynamic HTML update wonderland. Maybe, maybe not. Yeah, how should I? I wanted to comment here. Is this add more commits by pushing to the master? I slightly wonder if. Checks file changed, conservation, conversations, somehow. Anyway, this this stuff disappeared, so I hope this updated Git. That's okay. No question mark. Comment. And let's see, what exactly do we have here in this? We have only one commit, so not really sure why this lists here now two, but here is an X now, so whatever. Anyway, you see totally much more amazing than sending emails. And I hope you learned something together with me how to operate Git. We certainly need to more Git operation in the future, because apparently that's everyone's darling. Just that I'm a little bit of an old-fashioned yelling at cloud snowflake here. So whatever, I hope that makes everyone happy there. You see, even the only thing is I should not have committed this here with this hash if one. That was just some mental note of mine, and commit message, a little bit, in my opinion, it's a little bit too much nitpicking, but whatever. How's the latest we're talking since? There you see how much time is running trying to build a YouTube channel. Need to work on that. I actually have also some other stuff. I most probably, because we recently had some server hiccup, I'm actually also considering to change or add optional support with Dropbear SSH to the initrd, that you could do server maintenance, for example, when your LVM2 write stuff doesn't assemble anymore. That then, if that is a remote server, you can't really fix this, which, by the way, in my opinion, is a total bug and not amazing, but somehow too much stuff I'm taking a look at is not amazing. I really wonder why we still have issues like this after 20 years. But these hotkeys are amazing, isn't it? I mean, these are the hotkeys that we with amazing Sun keyboard, right? And I also, my opinion, the code is too large, too complex. But the next T2 ISO, so I have like two people who proposed Intanium IA64 access now, which is of course ironic when just this was deprecated in GCC, or is going to here on Phoronix. Apparently there is somewhere in Intanium or something IA64, here with dash only, real with dash. So just when people want to offer Intanium IA64 support. So even I personally have not encountered this often. I had a couple of times a possibility, but wasn't really that interested to have access. But even now then, for the vintage retro stuff, and again, not even as vintage as Hewlett Packard, PA RISC, and MIPS, SJOctane, and stuff. But why do I say this? I say this because this is GRUB or EFI. This is of course where EFI, Intel invented EFI for this IA64, and for that we probably want to do more GRUB 2 stuff. Not really sure if that is actually supported, but maybe I don't look this up now. It's enough live streaming for today. Already delayed the IT news for tomorrow. I say this only because that would be the next building construction sites for bootable stuff for Intanium. I wonder, maybe we could do this in QEMU, right? But that's something else for another day. This is why I actually tinkered and how I destroyed here the LVM2 boot stuff, because one of the major reasons I even tinkered here around with that is EFI bootable stuff with PCI pass-through for the GPU, which is I just packed the matrix away earlier in the earlier live stream. The matrix was still here, so I only irritated and destroyed, or half destroyed here, this LVM2 with resetting, rebooting, because this pass-through wasn't stable actually with the matrix card. But right now I have obviously the AMD card in there again for streaming with hardware encode, 0 drop frames, by the way. And this is how I destroyed my LVM2 test volume thing here, with resetting, rebooting for the PCI path through and that I not only do for all this T2 testing, but also Mac OS, obviously, among other things, or Windows, Haiku and stuff, you name it. And so much to that. You want to test this, because why do I still tinker around this? I have two issues with this. The first issue is why I've actually done this is I wanted to have here virtual machine stuff that is not only near native performance but also EFI, because otherwise I'm not usually using EFI in the virtual machines for, because you see it just doesn't work automatically completely entirely. This is, I think, what you mostly talk about, right? EFI bootable ISO. And the other thing is that the path through does not post the card, so I don't have EFI BIOS output from the BIOS post there, and this is why I wanted to have a second card with a Matrox for just €5, because we are cheapskates. Just that I wasn't aware of two things. Of course, not only has the Matrox card the mic cable, super cheap, but two things. Not only does it not have an EFI BIOS, I've not really thought about this, but that comes from being cheapskate, but nonetheless always good to test more stuff like non-EFI BIOS emulation stuff and such. But I also didn't really get the idea that this card doesn't reset, so maybe I then only later found out that for this kind of stuff the PCI card needs to have support for on-the-fly resetting, and not really sure if that is a board. I've not yet put this card in, because right now I've destroyed the LVM2 volume stuff there that I still need to finish recovering. And again, like the Git stuff, why is it so complicated? In my opinion, it should not be 2019 that this LVM2 stuff destroys as easily. Also all the code duplication, right? Why is there, if LVM2 is more amazing, well, we just see it's not as super amazing. I would have thought it's the latest and greatest and everything is more amazing except error recovery. That is much easier with the classic MD software write stuff in Linux. And again, why do we still have this if the future is LVM for a decade already? Why is not everyone using this? Well, why is not everyone using this? Because apparently it's not the most amazing anyway. I'm putting a lot of hope in your Linux. That's why I'm waiting patiently. Well, I hope it's not like macOS, right? It's like vanilla open source without any fancy patches and more like minimal upstream vanilla stuff like Gentoo, or actually maybe more like Slackware. And hope's only if you want a super vanilla minimalistic and of course flexible, right? All the build from source, all the automation and cross-compile support, like cross-compiling for MIPS and ARM and all the other fun stuff. And take the time you need pushing anyone, just remember not to forget. Yeah, you see, I even continued with this. It's only I wondered why, but it's also working on this, I discover new stuff. It could not even come to my mind that you need a kernel config option that I made the other live stream. And there you see all the education, right? Even I myself, I can't memorize all the 8,000 constantly new ones being added kernel config options there. It could not even come to my mind, couldn't get the idea that if I run KVM with QEMU and that tells me the VFIO, user space PCI stuff tells me you don't have interrupt reassignment, was it reassignment? Probably, I guess. Then I thought my hardware doesn't have this, the IO MMU with VTD doesn't have this. It could not even come to my mind. Actually, I said in the other video, then the Linux kernel developers really could have made this a option to not an option to have this, very simply not to have the text you don't have IRQ reassignment support, please enable IRQ reassignment or whatever the config option was. This is, by the way, commit here. If we click on the amazing changelog here, commit here, not reassignment, remap, IRQ remap is the option, and then with SVN, because SVN is so simple, just SVN DI commit this, so easy it can be. This was this config, this other was, so this I had locally, and the other one, so this I had lingering around for like 4 weeks on this machine. There you see on my data center I have 3,000 changes on machines like this. This is actually my portable SSD that I plug in everything, including the Ryzen build. So usually even here I probably on this I have even still all the GNOME stuff that I have not yet committed, beside a handful of other random stuff and you name it. Anyway, that's probably it for tonight. I hope you learned something, pro tips for Git. Please tell me in the comments how too stupid I am to use Git. And yes, I admit I've notoriously avoided this because I'm just, I rather want to do so much more amazing stuff than filling my brain with all the Git complicated Git magic commands here. And I also don't really quite understand why did they had to make Git that difficult to use. In my opinion, the usability, well, except maybe everyone is maybe using a GUI frontend, and I'm the nearly only one except Linus Torvalds left using it on the command line. I don't know. Probably you all will tell me that you're using it on the UI stuff. But anyway. Yeah, as usual, begging for sharing, liking and subscribing, because I really would want to do even more stuff, but in between I need to earn here a living. Still only at $3 YouTube AdSense revenue. And fun fact, I just sent new updates of our Mac apps to Apple, because that's what we do here in the middle of the night when we are not YouTube live streaming. And yep, I hope you learned something. Hope to see you soon, probably tomorrow, for IT news of the week. And we have updated this. I hope they accept the patch now and not complain about the next. In my opinion, this would be good style if they point out everything in the first place, but knowing this new, brave, new open source world, next they will complain about something else, and or maybe even about the stub commits, but I don't know. Anyway, keep your fingers crossed for this very small stuff. And again, don't forget to code every day, making the open source landscape a better place. And for the microkernel, for the microkernel stuff, I will for sure continue with this next, also doing some infrastructure stuff, maybe. So ideas to share this already on YouTube. Ideas not only, where did I put, here. Not only here, Transmitter, there's a very amazing scene, I'm so happy here. It's the small things that make you happy, right? Sending here patches upstream and doing amazing stuff, not only having your amazing Sun Vintage keyboard here for the amazing, well, amazing rubber dome typing experience, but hey, the scene buttons, it's so amazing. YouTube integrated. So we have here like 10. So I mapped this here, the first three are the main scenes, and then the second row, first I had this here all the way down, but that was not the most amazing, because harder to press the right one. So I have here now the three main scenes I use here, and then the second next with external shitty, but that's what we have here, analog proprietary crap driver stuff that I need to, wouldn't work right now because I need to boot the crappy special binary only Fedora core Snowflake kernel stuff for this bloody, also, yeah. So maybe next year or another year, certainly not soon, but eventually we need to reverse engineer this crappy analog capturing crap here, if we are not building our own one with Aston and Clifford's FPGA stuff that maybe we also take a look later. But otherwise, fun stuff we will do. So code-wise, virtual I/O stuff. So bare metal virtual I/O, block and network for our microkernel experiments, and then also which will be small things, right? So why do I do this stuff? To keep it stupid, simple, minimal. So that is stuff that I can do in a day or something. Or a weekend, or a flight, or on the beach, or something. My famous theme of other people play Sudoku or Tetris. I do some fun code on the beach, much more productive and something, in my opinion. And then also most likely bare metal examples for Spark and MIPS. And nowadays you can do this in QEMU, so you don't even need the hardware. So I will most likely for microkernel experiments stuff. Try to do some bare metal demo thing that runs in QEMU for just some printf and maybe frame buffer filling stuff, and then have those examples, Spark, MIPS, ARM, some, and also RISC-V, I heard that probably we'll get some very small RISC V things, so there will also be some bare metal in cases. So videos, you see we have a full schedule of videos, and just I overload you with random stuff that happens today, like pushing the skid stuff up, and don't make this stuff up. This is the review comments that you get when you do this, and that is why I want to share this, so not only the that you don't repeat these mistakes, you sent it already more code reviewed up and avoid the second step, and also how to use Git certainly, because yeah, stronger together or something like that. And yeah, good night, hope to see you soon, and yeah, stuff like that.